my mind, nor by power, but my spirit seeth the Lord. Amen. Mga Ikson, I have an announcement. There's not much that we can do without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. This building will not be finished without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, bisag unsang imong trabaho, you need to be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Teachers, you will never become a good teacher in your classroom without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. This is a non-negotiable requirement. Sa usa ka tawo nga nangandoy nga gamiton sa imo, pwede ka gwapong tingog apan walay gahom sa Espiritu Santo. Pwede ka maayong wali apan walay gahom sa Espiritu Santo. Good preaching will be appreciated, but it can never change the life of the person. This is a principle that will change your life. Result is not determined on what you do. Result is determined on who helped you. Bisag unsa ka pagkakuyaw, result is not dependent on what you will do. It is dependent kung kinsa ang mutabang sa iyo. Dagay mga tao nga mas kabalo pa, muwali kay kang Pastor Ulan. Dagay mga tao, mas kuyaw pa dito sa inyong trabahoan. But what really separates you from them, it's the power of the Holy Ghost. Ang ato ang paghahisgutan karon mga igsoon is entitled Empowered. Ang kinabuhi, kauban ang balaan nga Espiritu Santo. Anyway, karong Domingo, gina-celebrate sa tanang mga Kristohanon all over the world. No? Kanang gitawag na itong Palm Sunday or the triumphant entry of the Lord Jesus Christ. Mauni ang katingalahan kaayo, no? Kaya gitawag na itong Holy Week. And this is the only week nga dunay 8 days. Magsugod og Sunday, matapos og Sunday, kung imo nang iphon, walo na kaadlaw dong. Domingo, Lunes, Martes, Miyerkules, Huwebes, Biyernes, Sabado, Domingo. O, mura na'y Holy Week, nga walo kaadlaw. So, this is the beginning of the end of the ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ. Muni ang last 8 days dinhi sa kalibutan. And what is irony to me is that this week, people are ready to give him crown, but next week, people will demand that he will be crucified. Isn't it amazing? No? Karon, in love kay sila kan Jesus, no? They were so overwhelmed, no? With the miracles, no? Sa tanang mga gibuhat ni Kristo samtang naa siya sa kalibutan. And yet, on the following week, those people, the same people who will actually rejoicing with him, no? Moni ang nagbutang sa iya o katong mga palwa sa lubi. Samtang gapaingon si Kristo dito sa Jerusalem, no? Muna kita wagan tong Palm Sunday. Kay ang iyahang agianan gibutangan og mga mga dahon, mga palwa. I don't know kung lubi ba, no? So, muna ang history, and yet, the same people will also demand that he will be crucified. Mga Ikson, this morning, that will not be our topic. So, ako lang gina-set ang tone, aron i-ready ang atong kaugalingon that next week would be the Resurrection Sunday. Okay, our text this morning is found in Acts chapter 1, verse 8. In Acts chapter 1, verse 8. But you will receive. Everybody say receive.
Receive.
Say it one more time. Receive.
Receive.
But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. So mga igsoon, kini nga verse, gihatag ni Jesus Christ sa iyahang mga tinun-an, no? Prior sa iyang pagkayab paingon sa langit. O kung inyong maobserbaran, this is not a command. Dili ni sugo nga gihatag sa ila, kundi saad ni Jesus Christ sa iyang mga tinun-an. So doon na ba yung mga tinun-an din, he? Ingon siya, Kung muabot kaninyo ang balaan nga Espiritu Santo, makaangkon kamo og gahom. So dunay gahom nga gisaad ang Dios pinaagi sa balaan nga Espiritu Santo. When the Holy Spirit will come upon you will receive power. Mga igsoon, kabaluta nga the moment nga midawat kita kang Kristo, nagpuyo sa atong kinabuhi ang balaan nga Espiritu Santo. Amen. And that is why nagatuo ko nga ikaw dunay gahom gikan sa balaan nga Espiritu Santo. Nagatuo ko nga dunay gahom sulod sa ako, that is untap power. Wala lang may-utilize nga gahom. Tungod kay ang balaang Espiritu Santo, nagpuyo naman sulod ka na ako. And ma'am and sir, when a believer is empowered by the Holy Spirit, he will become dynamic. He will become active. He will become anointed. He will become successful. He will become productive and he will become extraordinary. It is my prayer this morning nga ang matag usa sa ato, umingon kita sa atong kinabuhi nga Lord, I am tired of this life. I am tired of this life. Preaching with no power. Singing with no power. Being a believer with no power. Working with no power. It's my prayer nga sulod sa inyong kasing-kasing, mabati ninyo ang kagutom sa gahom sa Espiritu Santo. I am tired of playing the instrument without power. That is our goal this morning. This is a non-negotiable requirement sa tanang mga anak sa Ginoo. Tingay mong katapad, non-negotiable. Kung gusto ka mahimong mapuslanon nga magtotoo, dapat gamhan ang imong kinabuhi sa balaan nga Espiritu Santo. If you want to become an anointed teacher, anointed musician, anointed singer, you must be empowered by the power of the Holy Spirit. In Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6, then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, nor by power, but my spirit saith the Lord. Amen. Mga igsoon, I have an announcement. There's not much that we can do without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. This building will not be finished without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. You will never succeed in life without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Not by might, nor by power, but by the Holy Spirit, says the Lord. You can never become a good husband without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Mga asawa, you cannot submit to your husband without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Workers, you can never become a good employee without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Oh Lord, have mercy. Hear me, please. Ladies and gentlemen, bisag unsang imong trabaho, you need to be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Teachers, you will never become a good teacher in your classroom without the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. And that is why I speak to you this morning, this is a non-negotiable requirement. Sa usa ka tawo nga nangandoy nga gamiton sa Ginoo. Pwede ka gwapog tingog, apan walay gahom sa Espiritu Santo. Pwede ka maayo muwali, apan walay gahom sa Espiritu Santo. Good voice, no, will be appreciated, but it can never change the heart of a person. Good preaching will be appreciated, but it can never change the life of a person. Only the empowerment of the Holy Spirit ang makapausab sa kinabuhi sa tao, mga igsoon. Gina-celebrate na to nga ikaw usa ka magtutudlo. Gina-celebrate na ko nga ikaw usa ka inhinero. Gina-celebrate na ko that you are a gifted musicians. Gina-celebrate na ko that you are a banker, that you are a manager. But please, hear me, please. If the only thing in you is singing, if the only thing in you is working, if the only thing in you is doing business, you are in big trouble. Tingnan mo ang tapat, you are in trouble. Kung nagsalig lang ka sa imong skill, O Lord have mercy. Kung nagsalig lang ka sa imong ikahibalo, kung nagsalig lang ka sa imong kusog, nagsalig lang ka sa imong kaugalingong might and power, you are in trouble. Because the word of the Lord says, it is by the Spirit, says the Lord. Jesus Christ said sa iyong mga tinunan, apart from me, you can do nothing. Apart from God, Almer, even small things cannot be done. Mga igsoon, results is not determined on what you do. I will repeat this one because this is very important. This is a principle that will change your life. Result is not determined on what you do. Result is determined on who helped you. Ang resulta wala nag-agad kung unsa ang imong buhaton. Bisag unsa ka pakakuyaw, result is not dependent on what you will do. It is dependent kung kinsa ang mutabang sa imo. Amen. Man can never change another man. Regardless. I need the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In fact, mga igsoon, daghang tao mas kabalo pa sa imo kay mukanta. Daghay mga tao mas kabalo pa mo gitar sa imo dong. Daghay mga tao nga mas kabalo pa muwali kay kang Pastor Ulan. What separates you and me is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. It's the anointing of the Holy Ghost. It's the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Daghay mga tao, mas kuyaw pa dito sa inyong trabahoan. But what really separates you from them, because your employer will sense power inside of you. There is something about this person that I cannot comprehend. There's something about this person. Ambot ngano? It's the power of the Holy Ghost. It's the empowerment of the Holy Ghost. Are you ready for this one? In Luke 1:34. Then said Mary unto the angel, how shall this be? Seeing I know not a man. This is the confrontation of Angel Gabriel kang Mary. When Mary make an announcement nga ingon ang angel kang Mary, Ma'am, blessed are you among women because God has chosen you and you will bear a son. Si pangutana ni Mary, how shall this be? Paano mahitabo nga mga anak ko, sir? The last time I check, wala mong koy boyfriend. The last time I check, at akong gipanguyaban, gibasted mangani ko. The last time I check, at akong gistok gani, wala mangani ko gipansin. How can this be? Maybe that is your question this morning. Paano ko maka nisan altira, Lord? How can this be? Paano ko mupasar sa board exam, Lord? Kulang akong time sa pag-review. Paano mahuman ang church building? I have only limited resources. Paano ko gamiton sa Ginoo? I have only these little skills that I have. do you want the answer? Do you want the answer? You don't want the answer. Undang natawa man din gusto rin. Do you want the answer? Say tubag sa angel. Verse 35. And the angel answered to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. It can only be done when the Holy Spirit will move upon your life." How can this be? When the power of the Holy Spirit will be manifested in you. Paano ko magdugay sa Japan, Lord? Akong kontrata 3 years lang man. Paano may mo survive sa akong karelasyon, Lord? 2 years pa ko magpaabot. When the Holy Spirit will fall upon you. Paano ko makasurvive ginawa akong swildo? Pertira mang damaya. When the Holy Spirit will come. This is a non-negotiable requirement sa tanang mga anak sa Ginoo. It's beyond our skills. It's beyond science. It's beyond physics and mathematics, Karen. It's the power of the Holy Ghost. It's beyond skills, Dong. It's the power of the Holy Ghost. Nothing can explain this one. Nganong siya man ang gigamit sa Ginoo nga makay na sila maayo because it's the anointing that separates you from them. Nganong siya man ang na-promote nga daghan man kay ko kanikuan kanang MDD na po PhD na MD unsa nang MD gani murag doktor na pay MD PDD murag doktor pero dili doktor no MP. Ano sana? MD, PDD. Murag doktor pero dili doktor. Nganong ikaw gyud? Nganong ikaw ang giris ang salary? Nganong ikaw kita kanong favor sa imong schedules? Okay, sa mga anak diri sa Ginoo nga nangapangayog favor sa schedule silang company. How can that be? It will happen only when the Holy Spirit will move in you. Tingin mo katapad, when the Holy Spirit will move in you. Matingala ang inyong employer. There's something about this man. Ngano magini? Di ko kabalibad sa iyang hangyo. Sir, pwede ko mag-favor, sir? Sabado Domingo, sir, ba ako unta ng day off? There's something about this man. John, it's beyond skills. It can only happen when the Holy Spirit will move in you. That's the favor that beyond the explanation of man. That man even cannot comprehend. Mga igsoon, dili ta kulang sa kahibalo. Mga igsoon, dili ta kulang sa skills. Ang atong kulang, it's the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Isaiah 32:15. Basa tang tanan. Until the Spirit is poured on us from on high, and the wilderness becomes a fruitful field, and the fruitful field is considered a forest. Look at the transition, what will happen. When the Holy Spirit will move in the life of a person, even a wilderness will become a fruitful field. And that fruitful field will become a forest. Can you say amen? Sa tanaw ni mo nga murag uga naman kayo ang akong kinabuhi. Murag wa naman pulos ang akong kinabuhi. But when the Holy Spirit will move in the life of a person, He will become active and dynamic. Wala kay maasahan nga maayo sa desert. Amen? Wala kay maasahan nga maayo sa wilderness. Ang nasa wilderness, puros ugaw, walay kinabuhi, puros patay ang mga sagbot. But when the Holy Spirit will move in that place, it will become a productive land. Can you still remember the ministry of the Holy Spirit in the creation of the earth? Genesis 1, 1 and 2. In the beginning was God, and the Word was with God. Adilita yung sasasayin dito. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the Spirit was moving, hovering across the land. You see, it's the Holy Spirit that is responsible in giving life. Amen. Managtiayon, kung tanaw ninyo inyong kaminyon, wala na yun, perti na yung ugaha. You need the Holy Spirit. Kung imong kinabuhi mo, wala na yun, you need the Holy Spirit. He said, it's my prayer nga one day you will come to a point, pingon ka nga, Lord, I'm so tired upon this life, God. Please, empower me. Use me in an extraordinary way. Lord, I'm tired of being an ordinary student. Please anoint me. Bless me. Mga igsoon, bisan unsa kagamay ng butang nga nasa imong kinabuhi. Bisan unsa kagamay. When the Holy Spirit will move, one day it will become a forest. Pastor Jeff, do not underestimate the ministry in Catalonan Grande. One day it will become a forest. Kana mga gagmay nga mga ministries, nga dili kinato ginatagaan og pagtagad, no, my dear. When the Holy Spirit will move upon that ministry, O Lord have mercy, it will become a forest. Kanang imong skills nga pertirang gamaya, kanang imong skills nga perting, kung tanaw ni imong murag, imposible man kay ni Lord, no. When the Holy Spirit will move in you, one day it will become a forest. This church will become a forest. The ministry of Hope of Glory will become a forest. I take that one, I claim it. Not just one, not just two, not just three, not just six churches. I believe one day it will become a forest when the Holy Spirit will come upon this ministry. Now, mga igsoon, how to access this empowerment? I want to be empowered. I want to be blessed, God. I want to be anointed. Ang atong huna-huna mong God, the Holy Spirit's ministry sa atong kinabuhi, simbahan lang, no. Bisag asa kang aspect sa kinabuhi, we need the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. How to access number one without further ado? Everybody see hunger. See it one more time, hunger. Don't you know that hunger is a sign of good health? Kisa gigotom karong buntag, taas kamot. Buti pa sabot, maayo kaglawas. Kisay wala gigutom, bisag wala nakapamahog kaninang buntag, taas kamot. Praise the Lord, kitang tanan, maayo kaglawas. Kung gutomon ka, it's sign that you are in good health. Pag magsakit ang tao, ang unang mawala sa tao ang iyahang appetite. Ang iyang thirst, di siya ganan minom og tubig, di siya ganan mukaon og kanon. Amen. Kung kalinturahon ka, di kita ganan mukaon, di ba? That's a sign that you are in trouble. That's a sign nga doon na kayo gibati. Pagwa na kayo gana, mukaon, buti pa sa buot, doon na kayo ginabati. Same as true with your spirituality. Pag, oh Lord have mercy. Kung wala ka na ikalipay mo ani sa simbahan, Lord have mercy. During Wednesday, something is wrong with your spirituality. Accept it. No healing without acceptance. Unsay buhaton sa taong gutom? Tanan, no, di pa siya mukaon. Unsay buhaton sa taong gutom? Tanan iyang buhaton makakaon lang, amen. magpakalimos dito sa kalsada, makakaon lang. Magtrabaho, bisag bugat nga trabaho, makakaon lang. Amen. Amen? Usay buhaton sa taong uhaw ang iyang espiritu. Bisag, oh Lord, bisag ulan. Bisag kapoy. Bisag hectic ang schedules, naa kay nganuman, uhaw, gutom ang iyang espiritu. Lingay mong katapad, gutom sa espiritu. Kung wala na ikauhaw mga igsoon, you need to pray this morning, God, ibalik ang akong kagutom o kauhaw sa imong mga pulong. Because this will never happen until you will recognize na giuhaw ka, gigutom ka. Katong gigutom, pakanon sa Ginoo. Katong giuhaw, paimnon sa Ginoo. Hangtod nga di ka gutumon, you will never receive the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Ang taong gigutom mga igsuon, bisan pa mugasto siya og kwarta, maning kamot siya aron lang makakaon. Bisang pag ang seminar naa sa Luzon, bisag mugasto siya og kwarta, okay lang siya, kay nga naman, gutom siya. Amen? Muna ang timailhan sa taong gutom. Kung wala ka na ikagutom, iksoon, something is wrong with your spirituality. And again, it will never happen without hunger. Second, obedience. Everybody say obedience. Say it one more time, obedience. This is a very important parameter sa pag-empower sa balaan nga Espiritu Santo sa imong kinabuhi. Kung unsa ang conviction sa balaan nga Espiritu Santo, there must be obedience. Mga igsoon, the Holy Spirit is living inside us, and yet, many, many times, we don't recognize the Holy Spirit inside us. Kung naabay ka ng, kung naamay ka ng gamahay-mahay nga Ginoo, it is God, the Holy Spirit. Ilhan ka na to ang God the Father. Ilhan ka na to ang God the Son. But only few of us kaila sa Dios nga Espiritu Santo. Only few of us. Siya ang pinakasuod nato. Siya ang pinakaduol nato because He is residing inside us, and yet, many, many times we grieved Him because we do not obey Him. I-conviction na naman ka, hatag. Again, you have to obey. No obedience, no breakthrough. No obedience, no empowerment. Manang akong pangandoy karon mga kwan. Ano mo, ingo bitong kapoy na mong kaanil, Lord, isin akong trabaho. Ang kapoy tigom. You need the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Basahon na ko na ito to faith. Wala na ko na-appeal diri. Sa tumang Acts chapter 3. 3:6 yata to. The trial of faith. Okay. But Peter said, I have neither, tama ba? Neither silver nor gold. Ha? Huh?
Neither.
Okay. But Peter said, I have neither silver or gold, but what I have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, get up and walk. This is the confrontation sa katong makililimos nga this day, wala siya nag-expect that he will receive his healing. Never in the mind of this man that this day, he will walk again. Wala gid siya malandong. Wala gid siya nagdahom. Ang iyang kinabuhi, rutinary lang. Nagpakilimos, expecting na dunay maghatag sa iya. It so happened. Nga iyang pastor ang ipangayuan, wagyo'y kwarta, puro sa pre-request, ang sulod sa pitaka. Biblical gid ini ano no? Ana, wag magi, bisag piso ba? Luoy pod mo ay. Luoy pod taon mo. Tama na gisitay sa offering, wag gi love gift ba? But Peter said, I have neither silver nor gold, but what I have, I will give to you. Unsa din si Emer?
Ha?
The power of the Holy Spirit. Igsoon, if you have the anointing of the Holy Ghost, you can feel it. You know it. Ingon si Peter, I don't have money. But what I have in me is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Get up and walk. Kana bitaw mag-ampo ka? Kabalo ka nga, kining tawhana ni. Maayo gini, I can feel it. Because there's something inside of me, I can feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Oh Lord, have mercy. If you can believe it, you have it. If you cannot believe it, you don't have it. Balikon ko. If you can believe it, kung matuuhan ni mo buti pasabot, naana sulod ni mo. Kung di ka kato buti pasabot, wala ka ana. Kana mag-ampo, bitaw ka nga, Lord, ayuhan tao sa kisa kong ipon, Ginoo. Pero murag wala lang. Pero kana bitaw, I know that this will be healed. Okay, kisay nakasuway diri na buntis. Kaagi ka. Tamso kaagi Kuya Dexter, no? Kanang nabuntis ka nga, kanang wa pagkakabalo nga nabuntis. Kanang wa ka kabalo ba nga buntis ka? Katry na sikit. si Marian. Nakaagi ka yan nga kanang buntis ka, pero wa ka kabalo nga buntis ka. Pero duda ka nga buntis ka, tama po ba? Mura, ma-feeling mo nga, there's something inside of me. Bisag, wala ka kabalo nga nabuntis ka, pero gaduda ka nga na nagisulod ang akong tiyan ba? Amen. Mauna ang bation sa taong gigamhan sa gahom sa Espiritu Santo. I can feel, I can sense the power of the Holy Ghost inside of me. I know that this preaching will change the life of a person. I know, I can feel it. Kabalo ko nga na yung mga panalanginan sa inyo, I can feel it. Murag si Kristo ba, ingon siya nga, nainihikap sa ako. Ano man, Lord? Nako'y nabati nga gahom nga bigawas sa ako. Kadaghan nato diri, Lord, I can feel the power living inside my body. I hope when you pray, you have that different dimensions in prayer. Pastora Jane, yesterday, we rejoice, no? Sa dahil sa itong isig ka magbubuhat, nakapalin sila bagong sakyan ng palakpakan na ito ang ginumaayo ng Ginoo. Before that one, ingon si Pastora Jane sa ako, Pang, I can feel na magkasakyan ng takarong tuiga. Ano din ko siya, Mang, if you can feel it, you will have it. If you can prophesy that one, meaning that is inside of you, there is a seed implanted in you by the Holy Spirit. You can feel it, you can sense it. Excited kayo ko, pang.
Murang mabuntis ko karong tuig ka pang-excited. Ano? Sakyanan. Pero okay lang kuya Dexter, sakyanan. Okay lang. Pang! Ingon ang balang Espiritu Santo sa ko. Okay, yeah. Hallelujah. Wala naging musunod kang Pastor Ulan. Wala naging Pastor Ulan nga magwawali. No? Muna mga igsoon, you will feel when there is something inside of you. Kabalo po ka nga, you don't have it. Amen? Every time you mubarog ka sa tabangang kabalo ka, pag wakay kumpiyansa sa imong kaugalingon, you don't have it. Ano na kasimple? If you can believe it, you have it. If you cannot believe it, you don't have it. Min, di ba kabalo ka nga ma-first owner ka? Kaya na ka ma-first owner ba? Di ba? You can feel it? I can feel it. Mag-feel na ko ba nga ma-promote ko karong tuiga? Di ba, Jason? Makabalo ka. You can feel it. Mag-feel na ko ba nga increase na ako swildo karong tuiga ba? Pero dili ni mo matuan, buti pa sa what, nothing will happen to you. Okay? Obedience. Okay, now. O sa'yo nahitabo, balik ta. Sa'yo man na faith. Nahuman, ha? Okay, verse 7. Then taking him by the right hand, he raised him up. Okay. Pag-ingon ni Peter, get up and walk. Naayo na ba ang tao? Wala pa. In fact, nagduwa-duwa siguro ni siya. Pagsuroy. 30 years na kong wa nakalakaw niya, palakpon ko ni mo, pagsure ba? So siguro, I don't know what to be the dialogue of this person sa kang Peter. Pagsuroy. Magkasakyan ang kakaroon tuiga, Pastor. Pagsure dong, oy. Mangani ko'y piso sa kong bulsa. Sakyan na ba hinoon? Ano siguro ka, no? Pagsure, oy. But when you start to obey, good things starts to happen. Blessing starts to fall in your life. Okay. Nagduwa-duwa pagiting tao siguro, I don't know, wala mang gibutan sa Bible. But Peter taking him by the right hand and he raised him. Sa diyang nagtuman ang tao, ay siya nakabaton o kaayuhan. Without complete obedience, akong i-emphasize complete, not 75% obedience. Ito, huna mo naman ito. No. 100% obedience. Excellent obedience. Atong topic last Sunday, na 75%. Until complete obedience is done, there's no empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Okay, number one, hunger. Number two, obedience. Number three, everybody say motivation. Say it one more time, motivation. If God will ask you, why you want empowerment kit? Why you want to be promoted? Why you need a raise of salary, Mer? If God will ask you, why? If I do this one, why? Nganong gusto man kamo pasar sa board exam karen? What's your motivation? Man nakitawa na to, big why. Nganong magminyo man mo? Aron makabatog pamilya, wrong answer. Nganong magminyo man ka? Gusto na ko, Lord, mahimaya ka bisan sa akong kaminyoon.
I will raise my family and bring all my children into your house. Magminyo ko, Lord, because I can feel that I am now a responsible woman. And I become a great mother sa akong mga anak. Muna dapat ang imong motivation, why? Dili kay naunahan na magkukong nila, we. Tigulang na manggiko, uy. Muna ito mga motivation, tigulang na manggiko, uy. Do you think, na ba imposible sa Ginoo? Answer me please, na ba imposible sa Ginoo? Man, God can give you a person in the right place, in the right time. God can give you the right man or woman. But the question, why? Do you think di ka pwede i-promote sa Ginoo? Do you think lisod sa Ginoo papasaron ka karen? Do you think maglisod ang Ginoo magpa-raise sa atong salary? The bottom line, what's the motivation? Nganong gusto mo, pastor, nga gwapo ang church building sa Hope of Glory sa Soray? The motivation is this one. So that people will know that there is God. Para ang tao sa palibot sa Soraya, makaingon sila, lahi ginang simbahan na ba? Mabati inako ang presensya sa Ginoo. God is moving in that building. So that people will know na basta para sa Ginoo, it should be the best. So that people will know that God is the provider. Naimunguta na si mo Brad Alan. Mangunguta na sila, Brad, yun sa ninyo na pagkuan, Brad. Ginoo ra gina sayo digso. We started that building, gamay ra gid kaya among funds. Pero God is good. Tell them so that people will know that the God we serve is the God that is the owner of all the golds and the treasures on the earth. Can you say amen? This is the most exciting part in life. Okay? Ayaw niyo kalimtini. Importante kayo ni. It will change. Nadiri ang tao, nadiri ang Ginoo. If your interest is direct to God, anything in between will follow you. Subliyon ko ha. Kung ikaw ni, muni ang Ginoo, kung ang imong attention naa sa Ginoo, everything in between you and God will follow you. Finances, good health, opportunities, ministries will just follow you if your motivation is the Lord. Muning irony sa kinabuhi, Marian, the more nga wala na nimo gipangandoy, the more nga maangkon na hinuon nimo. The more nga imong huna-huna ang Ginoo na dili na ang sakyanan, the more ihatag sa imo sa Ginoo ang sakyanan. Because God will say, uy, ang akong anak, nagbagong buhay na. Ako nang number one sa iyang kinabuhi, dili na iyang damgo. Now is the time I can give you a car. Uy, ang akong anak, no? Dili na iyang savings ang iyang number one. Ang iyan ang paghatag sa iyang ikanapulo, I can raise his salary. Amen? Not by might, nor by power, but by the Spirit, says the Lord. Mga igsoon, wala gyud
tay maangkon aning kalibutan na gawas kung ihatag sa Ginoo. Balikon ko, wala gyud tay maangkon aning kalibutan na bisan gamay gawas kung ihatag sa Ginoo. Muna dong, ayaw gyud kalimot sa Ginoo dong. Wala ginanimo na kuha ng imong forever kay gwapo ka. Naangko na nimo tungod kay gihatag na sa Ginoo sa imo. Muna dong, ayaw abusuhin na. Ginoo ang naghatagan na, dili demonyo, Ginoo. Kabalo ko, sigurado ko, Ginoo ang naghatagan na, dili demonyo. Amen? Dili kay gwapo ka dong ha, basig salikan. Salikan sa imong kagwapo ha. Reminders lang no, sa mga feeling gwapo. Sa mga feeling gwapa, nahuna-huna ninyo nga ang inyong kagwapo, kagwapa, kaseksi ang makapadani sa mga ulitaw. No! It is, oh Lord, it is the power of the Holy Spirit. Makita ang kanya lahi, magini siya. Ngano magini nga? Kuhan magini akong kuhan. Ngano man, lahi man ang gahom sa Espiritu Santo. Amen? So ito yung pangalan ni ano? Si Angelo. Lahat yung Angelo pag naang Espiritu Santo. Si Koan, kalimutan ko sa pangalan. Si Renren, gasa na agihatag sa Espiritu Santo. Si ano po, Angelo, gasa na agihatag sa Ginoo. Ginoo naghatag ana ha? Una, atima na ang usag-usa ninyong duha. Because you are God's gift to each one of you. Huna-huna ninyo nga, nakita mong gudmian itungod sa social media. No, it's not. It's the Lord who guide you. It's the Lord. So muna nga, ayaw yung kalimot sa Ginoo. No? Kung magpakasal mo, pakasal gin mo simbahan. Ha? Simbahan. Ayaw mo dito sa... Okay, John 17:1. Kung sige kong sa pulong sa Ginoo. Basa tang tanan, ready, go. Father, glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you. This is the principle of reflection. Unsa di kingo dia? Ituboy ang anak, aron ang anak mutuboy sa imo. Muy pasabot niya din, no? Ingon siya nga, Father, the time has come that you need to exalt me so that I can exalt you. Ang sabi na niyo? When God will be lifted up, you will be lifted up also. Kita niyo? Kung imong itubuy ang Ginoo, dili malikayan, ikaw mismo matuboy og uban sa Ginoo. Kaya nga naman, we are the reflection of the Lord. We carry His image. We are the likeness of God. Munang, malipay ang Ginoo sa imong success. Labi na kung ang tanang dungog gimaya ginahatag nimo sa Ginoo. When you glorify the Lord, you will be glorified also.
Kung imong itubuy ang Ginoo, ikaw matubuy uban sa Ginoo. Can you say amen? You will be lifted up also. Muna, God is happy, rejoice. God is so happy seeing you successful. God is so happy kanang seeing you rising. God is so happy seeing you in prosperity. Basta kay ang tanan maghatag o kahimayaan sa Ginoo. Why empowerment is needed? Nganong kinahanglan? Ingon ni Brad Allen kaganina, ngano daw? You shall be my witnesses. Kasi trabaho sa witness? It's the validator of the truth. Ikaw ang testify nga tinuod ang tanan nga gisulti sa Bible. Ikaw ang tigpamatuod nga tinuod ang tanan gisulti ni Jesus Christ. If I am a witness, mapamatud-an ako nga tanan tinuod gisulti ni Kristo. Amen. Unsay gingon sa Bible, God is good. Amen. Dapat makatestify ka na. And remember, ikaw ang unang object lesson sa mga tao. So dapat pagtanaw nila sa imo, tinuod yun ba? Maayo yun ang Ginoo ba? Hindi kayo pagtanaw kasi ka, ang Diyos maayo yung soon. Tanawang ka, nakagitlay mo ni si Brad nung so. Dapat doon na kay ebidensya. Empowerment is needed for the fulfillment of this divine assignment. I-emphasize na ako ang word nga fulfillment. Ang assignment, walay fulfillment kung walay empowerment. Ang imong pagkanta is not enough kung walay empowerment. Kaya ang imong pagkanta, ang purpose ana, ang assignment ana, so that people will believe that there is God. Ang akong preaching is more than just sharing the word. My goal is that people will know that there is God. Muna ang purpose. More than a preacher, I must become a witness. Regardless sa atong profession, regardless sa atong vocation, kung kita mga anak sa Ginoo, we are all witnesses. Amen. Okay. Jesus 1:6-7. Last verse. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. John. I like John. Oh, John. Okay. There was a man sent from God whose name is John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. Kit. So that all men might believe. You are there, not just to earn money. Muna atong problema because we never become a witness. You are there more than earning money. You are a witness. Ang nakanindot, he himself was not the light. He is just a witness of the light. Ayaw pong agawa ang spotlight. Dili ikaw ang spotlight. It is the Lord Jesus Christ. You are just a witness. You are not the light. Amen? Through your business, all men will believe. Through my singing, men will believe. Through this building construction, men will believe. Wala tayo laing purpose that all men will believe. Yan yung magminyo man mo puhon, so that all men will believe that there is God. Makita nila sa among kaminyoon, pastor, ang Diyos nga nag-usa sa amo. Ang Diyos. Through your healing, all men will believe. Through your teaching, all men will believe. Mga Ikson, every activity, every activity sa usa ka magtuto is always tailored for one, to become a witness. Students, be witness. Mga asawa, imariti si Kristo. Mga bana, be witness. Workers, managers, CEOs in the company, be a witness. It is beyond making money. It is beyond acquiring knowledge and experiences. It is all about being a witness.